Over the course of the following 4 days, I will attempt to show that Daniel Miller, while he's a quality human being, is still held back by the fears that have plagued him lifetime after lifetime. I believe that I can show, without a shadow of a doubt, that he must once again be returned to Earth to work on this problem. May we begin in childhood, please? Could we go to 11-4-19?
By the way, Mr. Miller, that signifies you're 11 years, 4 months, and 19 days old. Is that clear?
I think so.
Well, in other words, if I said 9-2-17, you would be 9 years, 2 months, and 17 days old.
I understand.
Realistic, isn't it, Mr. Miller?
Hey, Miller! Look what I found. Come on, give me that. Make me.
Stop it, everybody! Make me!
You know why you're not gonna make me? Because I'll beat the shit out of you.
You couldn't beat the shit out of me.
Oh, yeah?
Hit him, Daniel!
Hit him,
Daniel!
Low life, chicken.
Chicken!
Chicken! Chicken! Oh, that's too bad. Listen, why don't you come over to my house later, and I'll help you glue it back together.
Mr. Miller, would you tell us what you were feeling as you watched that episode?
It felt strange to watch myself. Is that what you mean?
No, I mean emotionally. What kind of feelings did this bring up?
Frustration?
It's not a test. There's no right answer. Is that what you felt? Frustration?
I guess.
Do you know why you were afraid?
I object. How did we introduce the word afraid all of a sudden from frustration to afraid? This is already pronouncing him guilty. Could we use another word, please?
What word would you use?
What word would I use? How about restraint? I think the little boy was quite dignified.
Restraint?
Yes, ma'am. May I show you what I mean?
Be my guest.
Your honors, maybe go to 1-8-17, please.
What are you accusing me of?
Nothing.
What are you accusing me of? Why don't you say it to my face?
What are you talking about?
Why don't you ever think about my problem?
Just lower your voice.
Lower my voice?
You said you wouldn't yell in front of the baby.
The baby? It's always the baby. What about me? I live here too. This is my house too. I work very, very hard to pay for this house.
You
no, you don't. The minute I earn it, you go out and spend it.
What do you mean? You think I spend too much money?
Yes.
All I do is scrimp.
Look, if you don't like it, why don't you get on your high horse and get out of here?
God, stop it.
No.
This happens every time you drink.
Oh, please, lecture time! It's lecture time! Why don't you just sit down and join the lecture?
Please.
Don't touch me! Please, just don't.
In that one brief, extraordinary moment when that baby in his father's eyes linked, this child learned the meaning of restraint. He wasn't afraid. He was mature. He was nonviolent, dignified, I call it. Now, my colleague may believe in hitting first and asking questions later, but we're not all that way.